So today we will be coloring my old Saint Martin wig. This was pretty much one of my first wigs that I ever made with a closure. As you could see, I had bleached the knots and then it ended up getting on the hair itself. And also the closure itself is just too thick, so I'm gonna try to like thin it out and everything. But overall, this hair was from Yolissa Hair. It's very brown, as you can see, so I want to color it jet black. So for this, I'm going to be using Revlon's Color Silk Beautiful Color in the color number 12 and Natural Blue Black, and we're going to go from there. I also have my little trusty brush thingy in my bowl just in case. I don't know. So come along with me as I customize my wig. So the first thing that I'm going to do is comb this out and get out all the kinks and stuff. It was freshly washed, but I just want it to be darker. I just want it to be black. So that's what we're gonna do. They be doing too much in these videos. Let's start from the bottom and like work our way up. As you can see, this hair still has all the bounce and everything. I love this hair. So we're gonna get this in order. I'm gonna start it up. I had to freaking dye my closure over because I got the dye in it, but whatever. After you do what I was doing, it should start to look like this. And then you leave the dye on for a good 25 minutes. That's what the directions say. So I'm going to cover it like so. With my trusty Bobby bag, and let this over it and take these off. Okay, so I basically already pretty much flat ironed the wig after I colored it and everything. And like I said, this is Yolissa's Hair from AliExpress, and look at that. Like, you got to come back. So I'm just gonna continue to, I'm at the top part of the wig, so I'm just going to flat iron the closure part, and then I'll show you guys the end result with me with it on and looking popping. Dye on the lace, so then I ended up bleaching the closure again, and then I ended up bleaching the hair again. So now what I'm about to do is put some makeup on it and go about my day, because I don't feel like washing this again, like wetting it again and then having to straighten it. Like, no, nobody has time for that. So I'm going to add some makeup, some like dark eyeshadow. So I'm going to take the black shade right there and get a little brush, this brush right here, and I'm going to add it because ain't nobody got time to be doing all of that. So here's what I'm doing. A little bit more darker. I mean, if it's not OD, dark, that's fine. But I can't have that bleached hair coming out like that. It doesn't look good. So what I'm also gonna do is add it to the part a little bit too, because I kind of got crazy when I was plucking this closure and I plucked it out too wide. So I hope you guys can see. Yeah, so I had plucked it out too wide when I did it, so now it's a ball about fix up. But since I've been making wigs after this, I kind of know now what to do. I just wanted to revamp this wig because I love this hair so much. So this is what we're doing. See, looks a little bit more closed in. Don't mind the little dark spots. That's the styrofoam head. See? Look at that. It looks good. Nothing a little makeup can't fix. Got that makeup, you got that cover up. See? All good. That is how you fix that little situation that I had going on right there. Now to deal with the back of this. The OG, OG of hold. So, as you can see, that is my Saint Martin wig, jet black. Get the OG, some nice old spritz. Yeah. Spray it in your hand like so, like this. Flatten it out in the back. Like so. Then we take this, flatten it down. she's on. You guys will see it better. Just want y'all to see that, like, that body. Ooh, gonna be slaying.